This little chunk of metal contains lithium. So does this cell phone and this electric car. The superlight metal is a critical component in batteries and the world's transition to green energy. It's ignited a global lithium surge in demand, which is expected to reach nearly 2.5 million metric tons by 2028.
Lithium is the white gold of the electric age.
China has become the world's largest lithium processor, controlling 55% of the market. To fuel its lithium supply chain, China needs to secure raw lithium abroad. It's making risky, major investments in lithium mines in Africa and Latin America in hopes of controlling one-third of the world's raw lithium supply, as it competes with countries around the world to feed a growing demand for lithium batteries. Here's why experts say China is trying to protect and expand its raw lithium sources, and how the US is struggling to develop its own supply chain. Before lithium ends up in all of these, it first has to be processed in refineries like this one, which transforms lithium compounds into battery components. China specializes as the world's largest lithium processor, processing about 55% of the world's raw lithium. After processing the mineral, it stays in China or could travel to Japan or South Korea to be turned into battery components. Those batteries are then shipped around the world, including the US. The US processes very little lithium domestically, and it's reliant on China's lithium processing. China, on the other hand, made significant investments in its domestic lithium refineries in the 2000s.
China started doing it because you need a lot of energy for refining. And you also need the stomach because it's a little bit of a sort of dirty thing to do. China manufactured a lot of these appliances, just got interested in it and got good in it. And then, of course, there was also this push by the Chinese government to electrify transportation and scale up electric vehicles.
China currently has the largest market for electric cars, with around 60% of global electric car sales. And those cars need lithium batteries, fueling China's demand for a reliable lithium supply chain.
Lithium is just incredibly valuable because it's an essential component in the technologies that we need in order to achieve a lot of our climate goals and to electrify the world. Now, in China's case, it's just been a little bit ahead of the curve. So for them, in order to maintain their lead and in order to actually make the things that they do, they need a supply of lithium.
But China's supply chain has a weak link. Even though it's the world's largest processor, it relies on foreign countries for much of its raw lithium, including US allies. Chinese companies also mine some lithium domestically, and they're fighting for control. Global lithium prices were about 300% higher in August than they were at the beginning of 2021.
In China, as is the case all over the world, people discovered that lithium is becoming a very important commodity. Demand for the commodity also shot up. So when the local government auctioned rights to explore a mine, the bidding war just started, and they submitted thousands of bids, and the prices went up.
One recent auction for exploration rights at a lithium site in Sichuan received over 11,000 bids. And the auction for the Jiada lithium mine closed at the equivalent of $580 million, 1,300 times higher than its starting price. Lithium is an abundant mineral globally, but it's often difficult and expensive to extract.
At the moment, China actually doesn't mine a lot of lithium. Most of the mining of lithium takes place in Latin America and Australia, which actually exposes Chinese companies to a supply chain vulnerability of getting the raw material. Chinese companies are really worried that a lot of the countries that are friendly with the United States might cut off Chinese companies' abilities to invest more in these countries.
Australia, the world's largest raw lithium supplier, blocked the sale of a mine to a company with a director holding Chinese citizenship. And Canada has similarly ordered three Chinese companies to sell their stakes in Canadian mines. Instead, China is turning to countries in Africa and Latin America for riskier raw lithium investments. In the past 2 years, Chinese companies have spent $4.5 billion on stakes in nearly 20 African and Latin American lithium mines.
The strategy to go to developing countries is not without risks, because a lot of these countries have somewhat unstable political regimes. They're quite underdeveloped when it comes to infrastructure, and if you want to mine and do things, you need roads, you need power, you need facilities.
Many nations are also tightening control over their mines. In December, Zimbabwe banned the export of raw lithium, instead forcing companies to process it within the country.
And then there's also something called resource nationalism. So a lot of these developing countries say to themselves, well, you know, we have these resources, and selling it as a sort of raw product actually gets us less money than if we have a valued added industry with that. So if we, for example, process lithium and maybe even one day produce our own batteries, because that's actually where you make a lot of the money. And it's also in a bit an opportunity to upskill your labor force. But that's obviously easier said than done.
And in Latin America, Mexico and Chile are also tightening control, while Chile, Bolivia, and Argentina are discussing creating a lithium cartel.
A lot of these developing countries come with their own risks. Chinese companies are also concerned that US allied countries could limit their access to lithium.
Some experts disagree that China is vulnerable to US allies restricting their raw lithium, and say that China's investments in Latin America and Africa are paving the path for a stronger supply chain in the future.
For a lot of these countries that have lithium, China is actually a very good customer because it has a steady demand for lithium. It doesn't just buy lithium for lithium's sake, right? It buys it because it needs it for products. So you know that they will be there tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. And that gives them a lot of stability in terms of the money, the revenue that they can get. You may not get the highest price, but you get a very steady price. And that can be very reassuring.
Lithium mining died out in the US in the 20th century because companies found cheaper methods to harvest lithium in South American salt lakes.
And because there was no mining, refining also left the US.
Now, the US wants to secure its own supply chain to reduce its reliance on China. But it has a long way to go. Propelled by the Inflation Reduction Act and a growing demand for green energy sources, the US is also increasing its efforts to tap into its own lithium deposits and construct domestic lithium refineries. Tax credits and green energy subsidies from the Inflation Reduction Act discount the cost of producing lithium by 10%, enticing companies to make American lithium investments. ExxonMobil plans on entering the lithium market by building one of the world's largest lithium processing facilities in Arkansas. When completed, analysts predict it could produce 75,000 to 100,000 metric tons of lithium a year. That would add up to 15% of all finished lithium product globally. But there's a catch. Many of these lithium extraction plants haven't been built yet. One upcoming mine, owned by Lithium Americas, contains one of the largest known lithium sources in the US. Lithium Americas told the Wall Street Journal that besides one other small operational mine, it has the only project in North America that's permitted and in construction. Its mine, Thacker Pass, has been in the works for 16 years and still has another estimated 3 years of construction to go.
It's an essential metal for a lot of the technologies that we need for the decarbonization of the world. Every country wants to get hold of lithium so that they can build those technologies.